Welcome, kitchen dwellers. Today we answer yet another very popular question. How much better is the combination steam oven at cooking compared to the regular ovens? And we will try to demonstrate the result by doing a feast of many different dishes. Primarily focusing on our main roast bird here, we're doing two chickens today, but of course you can also use the same methods to prepare a turkey as well for your big feast. Because there are going to be many things happening in today's video, we will go through all of the ingredients as well as the recommended trays that come with the ovens to use on these cooking styles. Of course, we will be needing some primary protein as our birds here. We're using two organic chickens because we're going to be cooking one of them in our convection amp-touch oven and one in the combination steam oven to see the difference. We will have some potatoes in which we'll be steam roasting and some delicious root vegetables like carrots and parsnips. A regular assortment of onions, garlic, shallots, ginger, and lemons are going to provide a lovely aroma to the birds, and we will have a bunch of poultry herbs like rosemary, sage, and parsley. Do not forget our customary Brussels sprouts, as well as some butter and some olive oil and salt and pepper for seasoning. As for the cooking tools, a speed peeler of a good quality will help you immensely, as well as a good quality knife for chopping. Also, you can use this opportunity to pretend you know your way around the kitchen. It is a good idea to have a bowl ready to contain your scraps for composting later, and we also have this thing here, which is the steam tray for our steam combination oven. We will be steam blanching our Brussels sprouts in this one. This tray here is the perforated tray for roasting. We will be steam roasting our potatoes in, and these miniature holes on the bottom will help the heat to go through faster for a more quicker cook. This drip tray on the bottom will help to capture any dropped juices. And finally, we have the roasting pan with the drip attachment, in which we'll be positioning our chicken on top so that the skin will be crispier and the juices will be captured in the bottom. Time to prepare our side dishes. So first, we're going to be making the roasted root vegetables. Simply clean, peel, and then cut into bite-sized pieces our baby carrots as well as the parsnips, and then toss them together with some of our herbs in which we'll be using with the chicken. Dress everything with a little bit of olive oil and also some salt and pepper, and they're ready for the oven. Most of the side dishes can be prepared in either ovens to achieve similar results, so I will be posting the methods on the screen here as well as in the video descriptions below. You can choose either one to achieve your optimal result. Moving on to the potatoes, this is also quite simple as well. Simply clean and peel your potatoes and then cut them into 3/4 inch medallion sizes here. I do have one lone yam from a previous cooking session, so in the spirit of not wasting food, I'm gonna include that as well. Simply toss them with some salt and pepper as well as olive oil, and not to forget a generous sprinkle of rosemary to give it a nice roasty flavor. Just as previously mentioned, you can use the steam oven to do a steam broil on these potatoes, or follow the other method in the convection oven, which will be on the screen or the description, to achieve a very nice roast potato flavor. It is now time to prepare our main bird, and we are using a simple lemon parsley butter rub for this situation. If you do have some nice shiitake mushroom, I encourage you to finely dice them and add them to the butter as well. This is quite simple, as we just finely chop all the herbs and add about 2 lemons worth of lemon juice into the butter and mix everything well together. This will be much easier if you are working with softened butter. As you can easily see, I did not, so I did have a harder time mixing everything together. So remember to use softened butter. Preparing the bird is fairly simple, provided that we have left the bird out in room temperatures for easy handling. Simply create a pocket between the skin and the breast meat like so, and introduce a knob of the butter mixture and flatten it for even coverage. We will be using some poultry herbs as well as other kind of root aromatics for stuffing the cavity, and please remember to season it with salt and pepper, which I forgot here. After everything is done, finish the dressing with a layer of butter on the top and drizzle some olive oil to prevent burning. And now we're ready to prepare the chicken for roasting. Now this is where the magic happens, the roast probes. These are the automatic temperature sensors for these ovens so that our roast chicken or other kind of bird animals will be cooked to the perfect texture that we need them to be. Simply insert the probe into the meat into the very center where it is thickest, not touching any bones or possible fat pockets, and we are good to put them into the oven and select our programs. Now that the chicken are cooking underway in their respective automatic cooking programs in each oven, which we will show here, I need to point out that the wired probe in the combination steam oven needs to be plugged into the left side of the machine, whereas the M-Touch convection oven will have a wireless probe, and we just need to make sure that the probe is somewhat pointing in the top right direction, and that's going to be good enough for receiving the signal. Now, before we forget, we also have to prepare our Brussels sprouts, everybody's favorite. Now, if they are not your favorite, I can change that easily with doing this. So we're going to be using the combination steam oven's blanch function under the special modes to blanch these vegetables. Now, normally we do blanch with boiling water, in which case the water will most likely turn into the color of the vegetable after the blanching, because a lot of the nutrients in the vegetables will be lost in the water. Blanching with steam, however, will preserve the nutrients and also take away the bitterness of the vegetables, creating a sweeter aroma. All we have to do is basically blanch the Brussels sprouts, then remove the bottom as well as cutting them in half to create more surface area for frying. After that is done, put them into a preheated pan with some olive oil and toss them just for a couple of minutes, and finishing up with a little bit of a balsamic reduction. Or if you're lazy like me, use some balsamic vinegar as well as some salt and also some honey. If you let the Brussels sprouts to char just a little bit under this method of cooking, you will taste an absolutely delicious Brussels sprouts as one of the best side dishes for a turkey or chicken. As the side dishes are coming together nicely, all that is remaining to do is just to wait for the bird to finish roasting. And using the Miele steam oven or the smart M-Touch oven is great because we don't have to time anything. The oven is going to do those things for us. And it is nice to note that although this oven doesn't perform magic like cooking a whole chicken in 10 minutes, the convection baking method in the automatic cooking programs will be a bit more efficient than regular baking, which means that the cooking time will be reduced by about 10% or so. After much delicious product tasting and debates later, we have come to a conclusion. Both chickens out of these ovens looked great and also tasted great as well. The seasoning was on point and also the roast was done to a perfection where the meat was tender and the skin was crispy. However, there was a subtle difference. The combination steam oven did provide a slightly more moist meat because it did have a moisture control in there, and also the skin came out actually a little bit crispier as well, once again due to the lovely moisture control. Having said that, there was no flaw in either bird. They were both delicious and we enjoyed devouring them all. And in terms of choosing the appliances for you, personally I do like this combination steam oven better because it is more versatile, but if you do a larger quantity of roast and everything, the M-Touch convection oven that is going to be the 30-inch large oven might be a better suit for you.